First of all, welcome Cliff and welcome Ray. Appreciate your guys' time this morning. And why don't we start with where we've been, like the last few years, kind of what have we been striving for, and particularly what are we building from?
So going back historically, we've had very successful ministries with the El Rey Theater, and just giving the college students an opportunity to take ownership of that service and really design it around what they feel like was going to be most beneficial for people their age to bring in the community and really grow together. And it was a really dynamic and great experience. And just with, you know, normal life, you know, that eventually that ministry kind of phased out, and as we all know, COVID hit. So, you know, some people look at it as a negative, but it really gave us an opportunity to really reshape that ministry and figure out which direction we want to go.
Mm-hmm. Makes me think about how not too long before COVID, about 2 years prior, or a year and a half actually, we launched our mission statements to join in God's restoration. And you want to comment on any of that?
It's a great history. And I think just building on what you said, if I were to jump into, well, how does it connect to the present? I would say the El Rey model of, hey, let the kids be in charge, so to speak, not kids, but young adults, let the young adults be in charge, which was kind of part of the story that I heard about the El Rey. It was a way in which I heard the story of the El Rey take shape. And I kind of grabbed that and was like, that's really good. That's a keychain leadership move. And out of that really became, hey, that's the one, that's the value we need to retain in order to create something like Praxis, is young people need to lead the whole people of God. So
one of the words I've most appreciated Ray use in talking about college and career 20s is the concept of agency.
Yeah.
Them feeling like they have agency. They're really empowered, you know.
That's
and
right.
So that's been really strongly featured in the last few years, and it's been refreshing, I think, good for our church.
And, you know, and when it comes to the decision making of the church, are we taking seriously what God is doing in the next generation? So that's also part of agency and voice. Mm-hmm.
I'm grateful that I do not have the memory of growing up with social media or smartphones, for that matter, you know. But, you know, from day one, our college students and career 20s, they were immersed in that world, you know. So they don't have that memory that I do. And it's just a different reality for them, you know.
And in a co-mentoring relationship, you're not assuming that you have the answers. You're assuming, hey, there's something I need to learn from your perspective, which is where empathy comes in.
Well, what I've actually really enjoyed seeing is when Praxis first started, there's some students that were coming, and they seemed very reserved. Mm-hmm. And as Praxis has gone along and Ray has been able to help nurture their growth, we see them up on stage. We see them singing. We see them joining Kidwell leadership. We see them not just pouring into that ministry, but it's spilling out into the rest of the church, which I think is just exactly what Christ wanted.
I want to say this to our church. There are no shortcuts to college and career 20 ministry. And the things that worked 10, 20, 30 years ago, they don't work today. It used to just be you have a couple really likable guys like these guys who would just show up and run a program. That's the best compliment you're going to get from me all year. you're pretty likable. Used to just be, you know, you get some younger-ish elder and pastor together who are interesting and can play music
and facial hair.
Yeah. That's right. And you know, you would build it and they would come. Today there's so much that is centered around relationship and taking time to get to know the stories of individual college students and career 20s. So I want to punctuate that for our church. There are no shortcuts. I mean, for any ministry, we want to say that, but especially now, the way it used to be is not, you know, how it is now. And we have to be really open to take some risks and I think to engage stories. And Pastor Ray, do you want to close us in prayer?
Sure thing. Will do. Gracious God, we give you thanks. Thank you for this conversation taking place in this holy place of worship. Thank you for the ways in which your presence is also in homes, in Bible studies, and community groups all over Chico and beyond. And the way in which that you call us to participate in genuine life-changing community. Lord, we pray that your Spirit would send us forward, a spirit of courage and love, a spirit of discernment, that we might know how to navigate this complex world, really with the values of Jesus Christ firmly before us. And help us to invite young people into that and help them show us and invite us into what God is doing in their generation. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.